Welcome to the latest edition of the ICC Global Events newsletter. It's been an incredible year with the excitement of the Cricket World Cup in Australia and New Zealand. Then that unbelievable turnaround by England, who had a disappointing campaign, but then managed to come back and win the Ashes. Unfortunately, the women weren't so successful, but they can be delighted with the increased exposure of the women's game and sell-out crowds at Hove and Chelmsford. Today, I'll be speaking to Andrew Strauss and Clare Connor about their roller coaster of a year. Clare, obviously not the results you would have hoped for this summer, but what do you think the girls could have taken out of the Ashes?
Yeah, I mean, there were, overall it was disappointing to obviously lose our grip on the Ashes that we've won over the last few years. But I think there were positives. I think there were some individual performances that the players must take real heart from. Overall, obviously, it was disappointing. But off the pitch, there were some great wins. We obviously had fantastic ticket sales. We reached more women and girls than we've ever reached before in terms of our engagement with a new audience. And I think we've really got to build on that. So some big wins off the pitch. And you know, everybody in the organisation working unbelievably hard to achieve that kind of progress for the women's game.
Yeah, you had two sell-out crowds at Hove and at Chelmsford. How do you continue to generate that interest?
I think we have to look at what we did that worked well and continue to build on that. We've got some exciting new talent in the organisation, in our marketing team and in our digital team. So I think we have to just make sure that we build on what we did well, keep momentum going. We've got some great women's cricket festivals going on at the moment as the summer draws to an end. And I think the way that we're reaching more women and girls now is what's really exciting. And we're diversifying the reach of the sport, and that's what, you know, we have to continue to look to do.
Another exciting announcement is the Women's Super League, which will be put into practice next year. How do you think that will help the England players?
Well, the main driver for that competition is around bridging the gap between domestic women's county cricket and the international stage. So fewer players, a more enhanced talent pool than county cricket, the best playing the best more often, more high pressure matches, more at stake will hopefully benefit the England team and those who want to aspire to play for England.
And just how important is that, Clare, with the World Cup that's going to be played here in England in just under 2 years' time?
Yeah, I mean, it's really important. We've got to put on a great performance at home here. We've got a massive opportunity to drive a real legacy for the women's and girls game. Actually, women's sport in this country to stage a home World Cup. And it's incumbent on all of us to absolutely make the most of it.
What are the plans for this winter for the girls? They're going to South Africa, but they also have the World T20. How are the preparation going for that?
Yeah, well, it's we're approaching the busiest ever 12 months in international women's cricket. Not only on the international stage, we've got 8 players going over to the inaugural Women's Big Bash in the coming weeks in Australia. So again, more high pressure, best v best cricket for them to play in. They'll come back, then we go straight off to South Africa in February for 3 ODIs and 3 T20s, 2 of which are double headers with England and South Africa men, so more profile opportunities. And then almost immediately over to India for the World 2020.
Do England have a chance of lifting the trophy?
The World T20, yeah, absolutely. I mean, one of the main positives through the multi-format Ashes was how well we finished. We showed lots of character and we played well in the 2020s, especially at Chelmsford and Cardiff. So I think we've got a really strong chance. We won that 3-match series, if you take that as a mini series. So we beat the world champions in that format, Australia. So I think that should give us real confidence as we go out to that tournament.
Thank you for your time, Clare. It's been great having you. Andrew, with this season coming to a close, can you just sum up your first summer in the job?
Well, it's been a mixture of all sorts of different things, really. I think it's been really challenging. So there's been a lot for me to learn in a short space of time. It's been really fulfilling. You know, we've had some great moments on the pitch, and it's been fantastic to watch an England team kind of come of age in some ways. It's been a little bit daunting at times, just in terms of the scale of some of the change and both opportunities and threats that are kind of coming up over the coming years and months. And I suppose it's been energising for me just to be back involved with English cricket and hopefully, you know, trying as much as possible to make a difference and move English cricket forward.
What has been the biggest surprise about the results that you saw this summer? Certainly with the boys winning the Ashes and then the ODI team doing pretty well as well.
I think without doubt the biggest surprise has been the transformation in one day cricket. You know, I think we kind of looked at how the rest of the world were playing and how we were playing, and I was thinking that's a kind of at least a 4-year project to be able to get our guys to play that type of cricket. And actually what it's taught us is we have got the players to play like that and we can do it. Now the question is, can we do it consistently? And that's something that's a challenge for us moving forward.
I suppose in the past, the emphasis has always probably been slightly more on test cricket in the English setup. But just how important is the limited overs stuff for you going forward?
If we're serious about winning the 2019 World Cup, which I think we have to be, then we need to rebalance the game. And so giving more importance to one day cricket, making our one day players feel valued and supported and encouraged, that it's not just a way into the test team. You know, all those sort of things are really, really important if we want to have meaningful change in our one day.
Bring it back to this winter and the coming tours. What are your key priorities? And then, of course, Sri Lanka and Pakistan coming over next summer.
Well, so I suppose if you look at kind of results-wise, we've got two massively important test tours, actually, UAE against Pakistan, and the South Africa tour. I think just the evolution of our test team, those are really important to be able to win away from home in different conditions, learn new skills, keep that momentum that they've gained through winning the Ashes. I think they're really important. From a one-day point of view, winning is important, but at this stage, it's about broadening the group of players that we have to work with.
And just lastly, how do you fancy England's chances in the World T20?
Well, I think if we keep riding the wave that we've created this summer and keep playing that type of cricket throughout the winter programme, so in the UAE and in South Africa, then we're going to go to that event with a huge amount of confidence. I mean, there's always the challenge of playing in the subcontinent and different conditions, and there are going to be other teams that are better suited to that. But maybe that's less of a concern in 20-over cricket. And quite a lot of our players have some experience of playing out there now as well. So, yeah, if we hit the ground running and we're confident after a good winter, we've got an excellent chance.
Thanks for your time, Andrew, and go well this winter.
Thank you.
So that's it for this summer's newsletter. We'll continue to bring you news, though, as we lead up to the ICC World T20 in India and then bring you news of the three global events, which is heading to England and Wales over the coming years. See you next time.